Hello and welcome. In this segment, we will be covering the recovery of deleted files, securely deleting files, and backing up files. When you delete a file on your computer, it typically goes to a recycling bin, a temporary location where you can retrieve the file later if needed. But even when you empty the recycling bin, the files that were in there are not necessarily gone. Without getting too technical, the actual storage of data is like a chalkboard or whiteboard. Have you ever entered a lecture hall or classroom and seen the chalkboard covered with notes from the previous class? Those notes have been discarded, but they are still there and still readable. Sometimes, traces of notes can still be read even after erasing the board. Similarly, when a digital file is deleted, even from the recycling bin, it's not really deleted. Instead, it is simply marked as available for future use. Even if part of the file is overwritten, some of it might still be recoverable. That can be a good thing if you accidentally deleted something you need, like an assignment that's due tomorrow. Undelete programs search your file system for files that have been deleted, but are still recoverable. Here's a tip. It's really beneficial to install such a program before you actually need it, as installing it after the fact might overwrite the files you're trying to recover. This also gives you a chance to test the program before you need it. Recovering files can be a good thing, but what if you're giving your computer away and want to ensure that all your personal data is securely deleted and unrecoverable? There are programs that can help with that too. They work by overwriting files with random data multiple times. This way, any attempt to recover the file will retrieve only the random data, not your personal data. Here's a file with some secret information that we don't want recovered. We now use a program to securely delete the file. It overwrites the file with random data. The current time is 6:29. To ensure that it's securely deleted, we're going to try to recover it. Here we see the file at the very top. It might not look like our file, but look at the last date of modification. It represents the time the file was overwritten. Even the file name has been overwritten, so it cannot be recovered. When we open the file, we see that the contents are merely random hexadecimal values. We can rest assured that our original secret data has now been securely deleted. Now, let's talk about backing up your data. This is important in case your computer breaks, is stolen, or your original copy was corrupted or destroyed. A backup can simply be a separate copy of your data that you store on an online cloud account, network server, or on removable storage. If you are backing up individual files, you can also compress them in an archive. Your operating system probably has some basic backup functionality built in. Alternatively, you can create a disk image, which is a backup of an entire drive. This allows you to restore your entire system, including your data, your operating system, and your settings. A disk image is useful if you need to restore a file you forgot to back up, your computer is infected with malware, or you need to replace or upgrade your hard drive. Remember, a disk image is like a snapshot or picture of your system at the moment it was created. But because it represents the entire hard drive, it needs to be stored on a separate drive. In addition, a disk image is typically very large. Having enough storage space is especially important if you are taking multiple images, for example, making a backup image every month. To address this, there are different strategies for creating backup disk images, each having its own advantages and disadvantages. Suppose we initially have 5 GB of data to back up. By the time another backup is made, 2 GB of data have been added or changed. Then 3 GB, and finally 1 GB. Having multiple backups allows restoration of data from different points in time. Perhaps you might want to restore the backup from 2 months ago, but not last month. With a full backup, all data is backed up each time. Full backups take up the most space, but they can be restored independently. Remember, backups are data too, and can suffer the same problems as the original data: loss, corruption, or deletion. In our example, backing up our original data requires 33 gigabytes of additional storage. That's 3 times the size of the original data. A differential backup has 2 parts. It starts with a full backup, but all subsequent backups store only the differences between the original, full backup, and the current state. Even if you have multiple backups, the data can only be restored using the original full backup and the latest differential backup. In this example, our backups occupy only 18 gigabytes of space. An incremental backup strategy uses the least amount of storage, but it also has the most dependency. Like a differential backup, it starts with a full backup. However, each subsequent backup stores only the difference between the last backup and the current state. This requires the least amount of space, but restoring the data requires the full backup and all subsequent incremental backups. If any of the incremental backups are missing or compromised, the data cannot be fully restored. In this example, our backups occupy the same amount of storage as our original data. There's also the option of a hybrid approach. For example, you could have daily backups of important files, like assignments or homework, full backups every January, and differential backups every month. In order to free up storage space, you could keep only the differential backups from the last 12 months. Regardless of how you backup your data, remember how important it is to backup your data. Applications can be reinstalled, but your work and your memories are irreplaceable. With this information, I hope you never have to lose any important data. Thank you for watching.